Okay, 1, 2, 3, go. MOBOOGIE. Mo Boogie.
Mo Boogie.
With me. MOBOOGIE. Mo Boogie.
Mo Boogie.
What up, everybody? This is Cindy with MoBoogie.net. I'm here once again at the Fox Theater in Boulder. This time, I am with Liz Berlin and Patrick Norman of Rusted Roots.
Hey, how you doing?
How are you guys doing today?
Really good.
Awesome. Well, listen, let me start off by saying that I'm a longtime Rusted Root fan, and Ecstasy is one of my favorite songs of all time, so it is a thrill to be here with you. Thank you guys so much for hanging with my buggy.
Sure.
Now, Rusted Root has been around since 1990, and your first self-released album, Cruel Sun, was released in about 1992. And what I wanted to ask you is, what do you attribute the longevity of Rusted Root to? I mean, how do you guys keep it so fresh and so dynamic?
I think it's the touring. You know, playing live for the fans, helps to keep the music fresh for us. You know, I think that's the biggest part. How about, what do you think?
Well, definitely that, and I think also, you know, we've been doing this for a really long time, and we've all found, I think, a really good balance within our lives with Rusted Root and everything else.
Yeah.
And I think even going away from it and coming back keeps it fresh, you know?
Definitely different.
I don't think we've ever, like, pounded it into the ground, you know?
Yeah.
Well, speaking of taking time off, that's actually one of the things I want to ask you about, because I know before your 2002 release, you guys did take some time off from Rusted Root, and as far as I know, you guys hadn't done that before.
Right. Mm-hmm.
So what was it like coming back, you know, and recording that album, and what was the energy like, and how did it influence that album in particular and the band as a whole?
Well, coming back, I think it was really exciting, just because we had taken a lot of time off. I think spending time away gives you the opportunity to, like, search different types of music and different types of creative outlets, and helps refuel you, you know, like, kind of recharge you, so when you come back you have a lot more ideas, and maybe it's a lot of different ideas than you ever had before. Mm-hmm. And I think that really happened for everyone.
Yeah. Oh, absolutely. Yeah.
Now, Rusted Root Live, an amazing album that you guys put out in 2004. Mm-hmm. Now, that was your first full-length live album, and I was so excited to see you guys come up with a live album, because you guys are known for your phenomenal live performances. So, what inspired you at that point in time to go ahead and tackle a live album?
Well, I think that, at that point, we started taking some recording gear out with us, and sort of was the first time it became really feasible to travel with recording gear. We recorded every show for how long?
Over a year.
Over a year, we recorded every single show. So each track on the album, it's a double album, there's 22 tracks, and each track was handpicked as the best take of each song throughout the course of a year.
Okay.
So I think if we were ever going to do a live album, that's how we would do it.
Yeah.
We would never be able to just, like, record one show and release it, because
we're so picky.
We're all picky
about, like, what songs we put on. I think we're all trying to actually let go of that a little bit, but, you know, perfectionism, you know.
Yeah. It's not a bad thing.
No, sometimes.
Now, do you guys foresee releasing another live album or another studio album in the near future?
I think it could happen. I think a studio album could definitely happen, but I think a live album could happen as well.
That'd be awesome.
Yeah.
Now, collaboration is a word that's often associated with Rusted Root, and I wanted to ask you to talk a little bit about what that collaborative spirit is like in the creative process in creating the new music. What's that like for you guys?
It varies. It's probably not as collaborative as people think.
Yeah.
It started out pretty collaborative, but I mean, Michael's the main songwriter. He writes, usually he'll come in with a song form to some extent, whether it's just a little bit or sometimes an almost fully written song, and bring it in. And sort of the extent to which it's finished or not finished dictates how collaborative it is.
Right.
You know. And then there are also times where we're just jamming, whether it's in sound check or at rehearsal, and something like we'll get up totally into a new groove and a new song will be born, and then that's when the collaborative stuff really comes into play.
Yeah.
So it's just like life, you know, everything happens a different way each time.
I think those are the benefits of, like playing out live, you know, because we have that opportunity to take sound checks and just mess around with, like, a live band instead of calling people into the studio on schedules and stuff. We're always together, so we can just jam and write stuff on the road.
Yeah.
So that's, like, another way it happens often.
Yeah, I would imagine that being together for as long as you have plays a lot into that,
too. Absolutely. Absolutely. Yeah.
Now, I wanted to take a minute, too, and also talk about some of the side projects that you guys have going on, because if I'm not mistaken, both of you have each released a solo album recently.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
If you wouldn't mind talking a little bit about that, that'd be great.
Sure. My project's called Digital World. That was the name of the album. And it's something a friend of mine, his name's DJ 7up, we were hanging out and just, he was hanging and helping me in the studio engineer some stuff. And we just started throwing down some beats like that he would create like on some Pro Tool sound software and stuff. And just like developed a whole album like just by hanging out for a couple months. So.
Yeah, it sounds really good.
It is.
Both of your
really
albums
good.
Sound awesome.
Thank you. Thanks.
Oh, you've heard him?
Yeah.
Oh, that's nice. Are you done?
Yeah.
Mine's called Audio Biographical, and it's basically, you know, sort of my history and my evolution in music. It's really like, you know, some of the songs date back to my childhood, and then all the other ones are sort of, I've been writing music since I was 16, and all throughout Rusted Root, you know, a couple of my songs found a home within Rusted Root. But most of them didn't, and it took me until very recently to become accomplished enough and I think motivated enough to put that into my own body of work. And so it was a kind of like a 5-year process from the start of recording the album to actually finishing it, and through that time I learned a lot about production and audio engineering, and so it's just kind of like this huge evolution for me. Yeah, so I'm really happy about it.
That's wonderful. I hope you both stick with it.
Yeah.
Good stuff. One thing I wanted to ask you about is I had read somewhere that it was a requirement to be a part of Rusted Root to actually take an African drumming class. Is there any truth to that?
It's just how it works.
It just happened to be that way. No, it's not. It wasn't a requirement.
Yeah, that's what it
but,
said. It was a requirement.
You know, how the band really got together, Michael and I knew each other in our high school years and played together off and on. When he decided he wanted to like sort of solidify a band, he called me up, we got together, and then I was actually in African Drumming Ensemble with Patrick and Jim Donovan, the original drummer at the University of Pittsburgh. We were in the African Drumming Ensemble together.
Okay.
So that's kind of where that came from, and you know, the three of us came in with like this, you know, strong front of African drumming knowledge, you know?
Jim and I were music students at the University of Pittsburgh, and we did a lot of percussion classes and stuff, and TA'd a few of them, you know, and we all tried to bring that element of what we were like passionate about in school into the group, and help develop like a tribal sound, and then we based a lot of the music off of that.
Yeah, that comes through very clearly. That's awesome. kind of a fun question. Have you guys ever taken stock to see how many instruments between all of you as a band you can play?
No,
really.
It's got to be a huge number.
That
we
would
like
be
our
interesting
instruments.
Research.
Yeah, you do.
We like our
you
toys.
Too. Yeah. And we like you liking your instruments. Awesome. Well, let's wrap up by telling folks what you guys have got going on in the near future. Are there any shows coming up this summer that you're really looking forward to, or any side projects that you're going to be working on?
Well, we're in the middle of a tour right now, playing through Colorado here, and I think we're heading off to, we're at Kansas City, I think?
We're going to hit Kansas City and Chicago,
yeah.
Detroit, on the way home, then Columbus, and then home, so.
We're actually wrapping up our tour, this is like the last week of it,
mm-hmm.
actually.
Okay, and then you have some time off for
Then we'll take some time off, and we're going to actually, we've been working on music for a new album, and we'll probably hit the studio when we get back into Pittsburgh, and rehearse some more and write some more and hopefully get the album out by summertime.
That would be very nice. Awesome. Thank you guys so much for spending time with me.
Thank you.
And again, this is Liz and Patrick of Rusted Root. Thank you guys again. We're here at the Fox Theater in Boulder. Thanks for hanging with Mo Boogie. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
Mo Boogie. Mo Boogie. Mo Boogie.net. Mo Boogie.net. That's what you get. Oh, boogie.net.